Welcome to the Azure AD B2C Architecture Deep Dive Series. I am Phil Whipps. I'm a Program Manager in the Azure AD Engineering Team at Microsoft.
Hi, I'm Gayan Randini, a Program Manager from Identity Engineering Team based out of Redmond, Washington, United States.
During this session, we'll be discussing the integration of SAML with Azure AD B2C. This will be broken into two main categories, SAML Service Provider Integration, where we will discuss both service provider-initiated and identity provider-initiated flows, as well as how B2C implements single logout.
And then we will discuss how Azure AD integrates with an external identity provider using SAML.
To get started, we will discuss SAML service providers. SAML integration with B2C is configured using the Identity Experience Framework policies, as opposed to user flows policies. For more details on configuring SAML service providers with B2C, visit aka.ms/B2C_SAMLSP. The first flow to discuss is SAML service providers, or SP initiated. The flow begins when a user tries to authenticate to a website secured using SAML. The web application generates a SAML authen request and sends it to B2C via the client's browser. Part of the URL used to send this request contains the B2C policy. B2C will then search for an application object using the issuer URI sent in that authen request. When B2C finds the application object, it extracts the SAML metadata URL. It then retrieves the metadata using that URL from the service provider, and it uses that metadata to determine how the SAML response should be returned. For example, will it be signed? The B2C policy engine then looks up the policy using the policy name from the URL to determine what the user journey should look like. B2C then requests the user to authenticate against its local directory, and on a successful authentication, a SAML assertion is sent back to the application.
Okay, let's talk about the SAML IDP initiated flow, which is very similar to the SP initiated flow. There's one exception, which is the application does not generate a request. Instead, the user goes to the generic endpoint to initiate the sign-in process. This also means the web application needs to be able to accept a token that is issued by B2C that was unsolicited by the application. The flow goes as follows. The user goes to the generic endpoint, and part of that generic endpoint URL includes the policy and the entity ID, which in the case of service provider initiated, will be part of the request. Then B2C will search for this application using the entity ID. Once the application is found, it will retrieve the federation metadata. The information retrieved from the SAML application object is used to figure out what assertion consumer service the issued token should be played to and other token signing and encryption parameters. Once that's done, the B2C will execute the policy, authenticate the user, and send the token to the application via the client redirect, so the application can validate the token and let the user in. Now that we know how B2C acts as a SAML service provider, can you show us how it integrates with an external identity provider using SAML?
Sure. As with service provider integration, identity provider integration also requires an Identity Experience Framework policy. The flow begins by the user authenticating to B2C.
Does this have to be a SAML authentication?
Good question. No, it doesn't. The authentication request could be any supported protocol, for example, OIDC. Next, the B2C policy engine looks up the policy to determine what the user journey should look like. As part of the user journey, B2C will be configured to use an external SAML identity provider for authentication. Part of that configuration will be the identity provider's metadata, either set statically or via a metadata URL. B2C then retrieves the SAML metadata from the identity provider, if required, and part of the metadata will contain where to send the SAML authent request to and how it should look. For example, should it be signed? B2C then sends a SAML authent request to the identity provider via the client's browser. On successful authentication, the external identity provider will send back to B2C a SAML assertion. B2C will then retrieve the claims from the assertion and generate a response back to the web application. Now we have successfully logged into B2C, let's discuss how B2C uses SAML single logout to end the session on all SAML applications it's logged into.
So Phil, to explain how B2C implements single logout, can you show us how it establishes the list of web applications that it needs to log out from?
Great idea. As with the previous flow, we'll begin by logging into the web application. The user tries to access the web application. This application sends a SAML authent request back to B2C. B2C then logs the user in and stores a session within its session table. The response is then back to the web application via the client browser. The user then attempts to access web application 2. And similarly, it will return to B2C using an authent request. And because B2C is already logged in, it will single sign on the user and return back to the application. And in doing so, we'll also add another session to the session table. The same then occurs for the third web application. B2C now has three SAML sessions stored that can be used to single log out the user.
Okay, now we have a list of applications to log out. What happens next?
So next, we initiate our single logout request. To begin, the user clicks the logout link on Web Application 1. Web Application 1 then sends a SAML logout request to B2C. B2C then iterates through the list of registered SAML sessions to determine the service providers that it came from. B2C then retrieves the SAML logout URL from the metadata for each of these applications. It then generates a logout response page with all the SAML logout requests. This then gets sent back to the client's browser. The browser then uses JavaScript to iterate over the logout requests and send them to the relevant applications. And when complete, the same JavaScript will return a SAML logout response back to the initiating web application. At this point, all web applications are logged out. So to recap what we have discussed within this session, we've spoken about SAML service provider initiated flows. We've then discussed identity provider initiated flows. And then we've gone into how to integrate B2C with an external SAML identity provider. And finally, we finished by discussing how B2C implements SAML single logout.
Thank you.
Thank you.